Hi, welcome to WebGentle. In this video, I'll take a quick look of the epic report of Jira Software. Epic report is a diagram of a complete, incomplete, and a non-estimated issues. But before going forward, I just want to tell you something about epic. I have already explained and demonstrated about the epics, what is epic, how you will create the epic in Jira instances in my previous video. So if you haven't watched that video yet, then please go and watch that before watching this epic report video, because it is very necessary to know more about the epic before knowing what is epic report, because these two videos are interconnected. I have mentioned the video link in the description box as well. Let me tell you a little bit about the epic. What is epic? Epic is a body of work that can be broken down into specific tasks. Task means user stories. So this is the definition of the epic. You can understand in such a way, or you can say epics are a helpful way to organize your work and to create a hierarchy. The idea is to break down your work into shippable pieces so that large projects can actually get done and you can continue to ship value to your customers on a regular basis. So this is the idea of the epic, but if you want to know more about the epic, then please watch my epic video of the series. Now we will see what is epic report. So epic report looks like this. Epic report help you to track the progress of the epic and the remaining work, and it is also help you to plan your epics for the multiple sprints. So with the help of the epic reports, you can plan your work in a better way. This report is also a board specific. It is also depends on your board saved filters. So this is a epic report. The x-axis represent time and the y-axis represent work, which is shown in two ways. In the left, you can see story points, and on right, you can see the issue count. The Jira software is already provide a lot of guidance to see how you can read this chart. If you will go the above, you can see how to read this chart, and they are telling you about the chart, what it does. So it helps to understand the progress towards completing an epic over time. This helps you manage your team's progress by tracking the remaining, incomplete, and unestimated work. So when I will come to this diagram, as I told you, like x-axis represent time and y represent the work, which is shown in two ways. And in the left hand side, you can see it is clearly telling you what is the meaning of this gray, light blue, dark blue, red, and the non-working days. So if I'll talk about this gray shaded area, this gray shaded area, so it will tell you the story point, and this blue shaded area will tell you the completed story points, and this one dark blue line will indicate the number of issues, and this red line will indicate the number of unestimated issues, and this vertical shaded area will tell you about the known working days. We can set the known working days with the help of the board setting. When you will go to the board setting and choose the left menu of the working days, you can select the known working days as per your planning. When you will scroll down and when you will come into the bottom of this epic report chart, you will see the completed and the not completed issues list at the end of the report. Now I can understand you're not able to see the known completed issues here in this image. So now we will go to our Jira Cloud instance and see how can we access this report in our Jira Cloud instance. This is my sample Jira Cloud instance, and this is my Scrum project, which is project A. This is a board of this particular project. When I'll go to the report, and here we have the list of the agile reports, and I will click on the epic report, and it is also showing here, you know, as I told you earlier, when I will click on the epic report, here we are. So this is our epic report. I can understand this is not similar to the sample epic report, because that was the sample and this is the real one, so it's completely depends on our activity. So here we are, you can see we have the drop down here where you can choose the epics. Right now I am seeing the report of the epic big feature one, and this is also provide the guidance how to read this chart. And here you can share that particular report with someone else. So as I explained, you can learn this epic report with the help of this guidance, and because it is telling you clearly what is the meaning of this gray, blue, red and this vertical gray bars here. Yes, so I was talking about the incomplete issue. So it looks like this, incomplete and unestimated issues as well. So this report will give you a complete overview about your epic, how many issues are completed in your epic, how many are incomplete and how many issues are incomplete plus unestimated too. And if you want to know more about a particular issue, then you can simply click on the key of an issue and it will give you a window of that particular issue. You can check the details like this. In this table we have key, summary, issue type, priority, status and the story points too. So this is how we can access the epic reports in the Jira software and how can you read that. I hope you can understand how you can read the epic report now. If you have any questions related to new understanding of the epic report, then please feel free to ask into the comment box. Thank you for watching this video, and if you like, then please hit the like button and share this video to the needful person. Thanks for watching. Thank you.